Alpha 6, Alpha 6, this is Alpha 1, copy, over.
Move your squad up to 220. Be advised, we have contact with Charlie in your quad.
Alpha 6, Alpha 6, this is Nightmare 2, moving up to 220.
Scorpion 1, this is Nightmare 3, do you copy?
This is Alpha 1, listen, any H&I fire plan.
Roger, Alpha 6, I copy. Alpha 1, over and out.
This is Alpha 6, H&I fire will be extensive in your area. Keep your ass inside.
Vietnam is full of strange stories. Some improbable, some way beyond that. This one story keeps returning. I heard it from Rat Kiley, who swore up and down its truth, although in the end I'll admit that that doesn't amount to much of a warranty. Among the men in Alpha Company, Rat had a reputation for exaggeration, a compulsion to rev up the facts. This wasn't a question of deceit. It was just the opposite. He wanted to heat up the truth, to make it burn so hot that you could feel exactly what he felt. Still, with this one particular story, that never backed down. He claimed to have witnessed the incident with his own eyes, and I remember this one night patrol, how pissed off he got when Lieutenant Sanders challenged him.
Bullshit, Rat. It can't happen that way.
It ain't bullshit, Lieutenant. I saw it with my own fucking eyes. It's true.
I say it can't happen. Nobody ships us honey over the knob.
Say what you want. I was there.
You just can't import your own poontang.
Yeah, well, this guy did.
His girlfriend.
Like I said, he sent her the money she flew over. Cute little blonde chick right out of high school. Got off the chopper carrying a Samsonite in one of those, plastic cosmetic cases. Straight out of the boonies, man. Swear to God, she was wearing culottes.
What?
Culottes.
Like Bermudas, man, only bigger.
And shorter.
So what happened, Rat?
I was assigned to this medical detachment up in G5, west of Chu Lai, near the village of Trabong. We had 7 other enlisted guys. We were there to provide basic emergency and trauma care. Casualties were flown in by helicopters. We'd stabilize them. It was gory work, but predictable. What you do a lot, you get good at.
Rosemount, November. Rosemount, November. This is Zulu. This is Rosemount, November. Copy. Rosemount, November. Be advised, I am in transit to your LZ.
Frank, this is gonna hurt. It's all right, hold on.
Bring me the crap!
You all right?
Come on, guys. Come on.
Okay, hold on, it's all right. Frank, hold on with me. Hold on, it's gonna hurt, okay, on three. 1, 2, 3! God damn it.
Set in.
Come on, Frank! Shit!
Oh, yeah. All right, don't listen to that table. Now you going home. You're gonna be back before
you
me.
You think it penetrated the fascia?
Yeah. Yeah, I gotta stay in this shit. Good, get this out.
All right, he's clamped off. You got it?
Yeah. He's strong.
He's okay.
He's okay. He's okay. He's okay. He's okay. He's okay. He's okay. He's okay. He's okay. He's
okay. He's okay. He's okay. He's okay. He's okay. He's okay.
Ideal duty for a medic, man. There was plenty of cold beer, 3 hot meals a day, a tin roof over your head. No humping, no officers, no spit shine boots, no snapping salutes, none of that rear echelon bullshit. The highest ranking NCO was an E6 named Eddie Diamond. You ever wonder, Eddie?
Do I ever wonder? Wonder what?
The peace and quiet. Why, we never been mortared, never taken fire. We're sitting ducks up here, fool on a hill.
Yeah, so what?
Mr. Charles comes walking past every night, straight down Main Street into the village to sleep with his mama, son. He don't ever fuck with us. It's got to make you wonder.
What are you doing, Rat? Are you trying to depress me? Don't start your depressing shit today, okay?
You want to know why he don't fuck with us?
Because we're cool. No, Rat. I don't want to know why, but you're going to tell me anyway, right?
You don't fuck with us because we're doing Charlie a favor.
We're doing Charlie a favor?
Yeah, that's right, Fosse.
Now, what favor's that?
Mr. Charles looks up at us and all he sees are 8 medics whose job it is to save our boys by cutting off their feet and legs, whatever, you dig? So instead of Mom and Dad getting some nice clean telegram from the Secretary of the Army saying how their boy died bravely in combat defending democracy in the American way, they get Junior back in a wheelchair. Stumps where his basketball sneakers used to be. Mr. Charles, he's smart like that, my wide-eyed friend from Kansas.
Ohio. From Ohio, Rat. Cleveland, Ohio.
Yeah, whatever.
There they go.
What's up?
The greenies.
Knock, knock. Payback time, Mr. Charles.
No social animals, that group.
Animals, but definitely not social.
One of them came by the OR last week, wanted some Surettes.
Hope you said yes.
Yes, hell, yes, sir. Gave him a box full. So happy he offered me his good luck charm. Said it'd protect me from evil.
Did you take it?
Fuck no. Don't need no VC here. Have a nice day.
I wouldn't go pissing off any of them greenies.
They were cool. He smiled, took the morphine, and split.
With the ear?
Fuck yeah. They got balls, you gotta give them that.
They got fried brains is what they got.
You know, sometimes I think we're in that place, you know, like the movie we saw last month. You know, the one in the mountains with the old guy who had all the answers.
You mean Shangri-La?
Yeah, that's it, Fosse. Shangri-fucking-La. Way up in the Himalayas where it's cool. Far away from this shit. Far fucking away.
So like I was saying, one of the pilots, a Marine from 106 Tactical, he's out flying recon in Sector 5. He spots this old landing strip right over the Cambodian border.
How'd he know it was over the border?
Fuck, the guy's a pilot, right? So anyway, he sets his bird down, but curious, you know? Solid as a rock. So him and his pals, they come back, they try it a few more times.
Sounds like bullshit to me.
Fuck you, Rat. This is the story. They get this idea. They get their supply sergeant to ferry over some goods. Trailers and tents and generators. I mean, the whole nine yards. Then they put their box together. They import some Buku Mamasans from Saigon. Unbelievable. They fly them in. Real beauties, too.
They flew girls into this landing strip?
It's more than just a landing strip now, Foss. It's like a regular fucking weekend resort. They got everything over there, right in the middle of fucking Sector 5. Booze, smoke, air-conditioned quarters, steaks, chops.
Sounds like a marine bullshit storm to me.
That's what I heard.
Hey, Bobby, this place still happening, right?
They dumped an F-4 in the middle of a rainstorm. The thing slid right off the end of the runway, which was short anyway, so. They had a call on a May Day, and that was the end of it.
You know what, Bobby? That's a good story. 3 years in this country, I've heard some serious class A bullshit.
Oh, Mr. Diamond. The house is full. Jackson Pants. Yeah. Give me my cigarettes. I gotta go take a crap.
Hey, Shushan, you wanna play?
Yeah, man.
Hey, Shushan, you got any Blue Oyster Cult?
Blue motherfucking what?
That's what we ought to do.
What?
Pull some bucks, my boy. Import some of our own mamasans from Saigon. Spice things up a little bit.
Yeah, so we could have our own little EM club right here.
Why not? We pay our fucking dues, right?
I mean, we don't have any officers or anything to clamp down on us and bust our balls.
Yeah, we could fly in with Wild Bill in the supply chop.
Darvon dreams, Eddie. Better off just playing cards.
So we'll be playing.
5-card draw, aces high. Jack's wild.
Yes, he is. Hey, Rat. You know, you think about it, it's not that crazy. You could actually do it.
What?
You know, bring in a girl. I mean, what's the big deal?
Nothing. Except the war.
Well, you see, that's the thing. There's no war here. It's not that hard. Have to have a set of brass balls, that's all.
You'd best strap your dick to your leg, Fozzie.
So what happened?
Like I said, it took about 3 weeks. Maybe a little more. Maybe a month.
We'll see.
Here goes something.
Thank you. Thank you. Look at me.
Look at you.
What's this, huh?
It's growing.
Oh, you got lipstick. Look at this. Hmm?
Guys, it's Marianne. Took a few bucks, that's for sure. Logistics, they were a bitch, but doable. Basically, Cleveland, LA, with a 4-hour layover, then a Pan Am flight to Bangkok. And then, this is the tricky part, Bangkok to Saigon, on a Brana flight full of officers' wives on R&R.
I'll be a son of a bitch.
Then a C-130 out of Saigon to Chulai, with Navy nurses on it, but, you know.
She told him she was a nurse? That was slick.
She spent the night at the USO club.
I don't believe it.
I'm smart.
Just like one of the boys in the band.
That's right. Next morning, she hops on a resupply chopper with Wild Bill, and here she is. It's tough, but it ain't like sending a man to the moon.
Well, hell, Foxy, get me a pencil so I can get my lady over here.
You just gotta want it enough shoeshine, that's all.
It's good to have you here, Marianne. Welcome to Nam.
Here, welcome to Nam.
Thank you.
Hey, Fosse. How are you gonna get her back?
Bobby D, squeeze in. Come on. Okay, now everybody smile. Okay.
What's with you?
Like a dream, can't I?
I was feeling kind of seasick. The crowd called out for more. The room was humming harder.
What's that?
It's the greenies.
The greenies? What's the greenies?
The mean green killing machine.
They with us?
Sort of. Not really. You must be beat.
Mm.
No?
Mm.
Let's go down.
I had this funny feeling. It was like the way I felt before I got here. Hopeful, I guess. She was a piece of home right here with us. She was Fosse's girl, all right, but in a way, she already belonged to all of us. Everything seemed better somehow. Even the stinking monsoon air smelled good.
Thank you.
They stuck together like a couple of high school steadies. It was corny the way they mooned over each other, always holding hands, always laughing at some private joke. There was some envy among the medics. It was Vietnam, after all. Marianne Bell was an attractive girl. Everybody liked her. Too wide in the shoulders, maybe, but man, she had terrific legs.
Nice to hear a girl laughing like that. An American girl, you know?
Eddie thought she was good for morale.
Slice the wire thin.
A little bit.
Jesus Christ. Don't go sneaking up on us like that, little girl.
I'm sorry. What are you doing?
You ever seen a trip flare?
Mm-mm.
Is that enough for you?
Yeah.
This is a trip flare. You see this little wire running out of the side there?
Hmm?
Well, some sappers try crawling through our perimeter some night.
Well, sappers? What are sappers?
As in Mr. Charles.
Yeah, VC. Viet Cong. Victor Charles. They try sneaking through, they're gonna trip this here wire. This flare goes off, and at 30 meters, this flare fires. Boom! Lights up Charlie and the whole goddamn sector. Bright as daylight.
Really? Well, what happens then?
Then we get him with the claymores.
Claymores?
Claymores. Any personnel mind. Take my hand. Grab your hat and watch the wire. Hold up here. There they are.
We got them spread out all along the perimeter, about every 20 meters. The wire runs back to the fire command bunker. We catch Charlie under them flares, all we gotta do is flick the switch.
Those mines spray 3,200 pieces of razor-sharp U.S. steel, 2,800 feet per second, in a 180 arc. Nothing walks away in one piece.
So never gone out?
Once. It only got blood and fur. Eddie said it was a tiger.
Tiger?
Oh, yeah. We got tigers in Vietnam, man.
Can I touch you?
Sure. Just be gentle.
Looks like a pirate.
Time we drove to Bryant Lake. Now we're on that dirt road exploring. We came to that old house and asked for some water, and that old couple, they asked us in for cider. I wonder if they're still alive.
Remember the pictures?
Yeah.
Remember them just like laid out? All their children and all their grandchildren.
Be like that someday. Old and dignified. We'll ask people to come in and have some cider and look at all the pictures of our kids and grandkids so proud. Don't you think?
I see Marianne.
I believe I saw her heading toward the west sector.
The Arvin? She said she wanted to hang out with the natives.
Trương thương mày nói gì? Mày nói mày chuyện nào ngu vậy vậy?
Chưa.
Chưa mày đưa tao hi cái like coi.
Bà mẹ đó.
Mẹ mày ngu vậy, hi cái like biết nữa. Gặp, đi chết đi mày.
Chào.
Chào.
Chào. Rice? Rice?
Cơm trắng.
Cơm trắng. Cơm trắng.
Cơm trắng.
Cơm trắng. Cơm trắng. Fish.
Cá.
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 Cá. Cá. Okay, birds. The birds.
Chim.
Chim. Chim. Birds, chim, rice, cơm trắng, and fish. Cá.
Tengo la Z.
What?
Tengo la Z. What is your name, miss?
Oh, Marianne. Marianne. And, Tenong la Z.
La Z.
Tenong la Z.
Chunlu.
Twinlu. Twinlu. Oh, me? It's good. Tot com chang.
What is this? What is this?
Kom Trang Suka.
Kom what?
Kom Trang Suka. It's Vietnamese. It's like, it's rice with fish and onions and... You want some?
Thanks.
What? Hey, come on, guys. I made it myself. Try it.
You expect us to eat this?
Won't kill you, rat. Try it. You might like it.
Well, what is this green stuff here?
It's a stuffy...
You know what? It ain't soul food, but I like it.
Our own little native.
Well, I'm here. Might as well learn something.
It's not safe.
You keep saying that, but what do you mean?
Listen, sweetheart. It's not like visiting the neighbors across the street back home. I mean, Charlie owns that village. In the day, yeah, the old ladies will smile at you. At night, they're feeding their VC husbands and sons and planning on ways of killing us.
Go just for a little while.
No.
I just want to see what you've seen. Don't you? I just want to see it with my own eyes, okay? Hey. You just have to remember they're just like us. Okay?
Okay. Okay. Cool. Okay.
Thank you. Hello? Tenang lagi. Tenang lagi. Kuan.
Con ơi, đi vô nhà. Lẹ lên, lính Mỹ lẹ lên.
Isn't he beautiful?
A few years, he'd be just like his father. Another VC with an AK-47.
Don't say things like that.
Go. Come on, honey, let's not press our luck, all right? It's enough.
She's a real tiger. Take up guts, train up raw brains. She'll learn.
That's the scary part. She will definitely learn.
Swimming around like she was back home at some beach. That girl was dumb, all right?
She wasn't dumb. That's not what I said. She was young, that's all. Just like we were. The only difference was she was a girl and didn't amount to jack shit. She came in with all that romantic bullshit. Just like us. But she learned fast.
Oh, shit.
You don't believe me? Fine. You don't know nothing about human nature. You don't know jack shit about the fucking now.
I need a trach over here. Come on.
I got you.
Fuck, Eddie. Eddie, give me a little pressure here. Right. Yeah. Yeah, like a garden hose.
Got it.
Yeah.
I'm clear
of it. Shit. Marianne, hand me those compresses.
Big fat leader, man.
Okay. Bell, hand me those bandages. Marianne, please, I'm losing them. Please help me. Now, the bandages! There you go. Good.
I see it.
Here, hold the clamp. Come on. Hold the clamp right there. Give me your finger. Come on. Good. Right there. That's my girl. Okay. Watch your hands. Good girl. Okay.
You all right? You're doing great.
Yeah.
Keep the pressure on. There. Please stop. You all right?
Yeah.
Okay. You did good.
Good in there.
Fosse.
Wild Bill just said the 4th of the 101st just ran and made contact with an NVA battalion just north of Quantry. Looks like things are gonna get busy around here.
Magazine, bolt, charging handle. Okay, now hold the weapon up off the ground. The charging handle, stick it in the receiver. Make sure it locks in there. Good. Keep it horizontally. Now the bolt, slide it in there with it. Close it up, push the pin. 19 rounds of full metal jacket. Jamming? Yeah. Good. Okay. Chamber around.
Uh-oh. Now she's armed and dangerous.
You better keep your head down, Rat.
You want to give it a go? All right, there's your target, Marianne. Shoulder the weapon, pull it in tight. Put your cheek flat up against the stock. Yeah, like that. Don't be afraid of it. It's your best friend in Nam. Slip the safety. Don't jerk the trigger. Just squeeze.
Now see, that there is a confirmed kill.
Never liked that fucking tree.
That's one tree that ain't gonna cause us no more trouble, no sir.
Yo, Eddie, be careful in case those chickens stage a counterattack.
Don't mind them, you had the weapon on full automatic.
Let me try again.
Yeah?
Against, right? And just squeeze.
Just squeeze.
Damn. I'd be careful what I say to the missus from now on.
You shit.
Okay. Gotta be all right. Gotta be okay.
Get this guy! Get this guy! Come on, let's move! Move him out! Get him!
Morning, Val. Yeah. Pass me those clamps. Right there.
Thanks. Superman.
Hey. This is gonna hurt.
No, look at me.
Got it.
Who's a brave one? Who's a brave one?
Why don't you give the corporal his present there? That's gotta feel a lot better.
Shoeshine, bring me a drip.
Right. Sounds like a tidal wave. All right, boss. Got it. Ready to drain him?
I'm gonna drain.
Who's going home? Who's going home?
Here, get him up.
You ready?
Thinking. Maybe it's time to think about heading home.
Okay. Everything I want's right here. Right here.
Oh, come on, Shushan. You gotta make that point.
Hey, it ain't my sport, baby.
Who the fuck is busting
cat? Relax. It's Marianne. She's practicing.
I think I liked it a lot better when she was cooking that Coom Trang shit.
Yeah, well, I think it's why she knows what to do in case.
In case of what?
In case Charlie decides to pay us a visit one night, that's what.
Eddie, throw back the ball.
I'm just saying there's a fucking war going on out there in case anybody's forgot.
The girl does what she wants. It's cool.
You know what the Greeks call them, don't you? Amazons.
Amazons?
Amazons. Women warriors.
I thought Amazons were fat chicks.
Take a few stitches.
What's that?
Novocaine.
Forget it.
I got a lot of sewing to do. I can't have you jumping around.
I won't.
Hey! 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 Hey!
There's the rice and beans still hot in the cooker.
No. I'm not hungry. Thanks.
Would you put that shit away?
Put it away.
Where you been?
Just down.
You know, Marianne, you can't just go out walking out here.
I found something. Beautiful, isn't it?
I'm sorry, Fosse, but you gotta love that, man. Your lady's been collecting butterflies in the Nom.
It's beautiful.
So I got him quartered in the back of the bunker. This was the biggest fucking rat I ever seen. Kaysan was overrun with these things. Biggest cats. Twice as aggressive. You'd hear them all night like this, running over you while you're sleeping. So now I grab a shovel, right, and I'm ready to bash this fucker's brains in. When he gives me one of these, and bing, jumps right at me, bites me right on the fucking face. I still have a scar. You see it? Had to get rabies shots and everything.
Did you get rabies?
No, I'm saying I could have got rabies. Shots hurt like a bitch, too.
How's the rat?
Fuck you, how's the rat? Please, Eddie, with the show-yo, give it a rest.
Okay.
What do you mean?
I don't know. You seem quiet lately. Different. Look, if something's wrong, you should tell me. I mean, we could... If you're unhappy...
Tell you the truth?
Yeah.
I've never been happier. Never.
Sleeping with somebody, Rat. I know she is. Just
whoa, slow down.
I don't know what to do.
Start from the start. Sleeping with who?
I don't know who. Eddie.
Eddie?
Yeah, it has to be. The guy's always there. He's always hanging on her, giving her things.
Whoa. Okay. Why don't you just check the box?
I can't, Rat. What am I gonna do if she's there? If she's...
Okay. I'll check it out.
present accounted for. No extras.
Eddie.
Garvon dreams, man. He's out like a light. Maybe she just went camping. You don't sleep under the stars or something. She checked the compound.
Yeah, I did.
Shit. I'll check it with you one more time. Check the wire again. So what's your guess? Where was she?
The Greenies.
You got it.
No other option?
No other option. She was with the Greenies. But it wasn't like what Fosse thought. I mean, she wasn't sleeping with him or anything. Well, not exactly. In a weird kind of way, it was like she was sleeping with all of them. But they weren't having sex or anything. See, they were just lying down, so to speak.
Lying down?
Lying down.
Lying down how?
In fucking ambush. Marianne had gone out on fucking ambush with the Green Berets all fucking night long.
Please don't say a word. I'm just... We'll talk later, okay?
Not later. Now! I'm talking now!
Uh-oh. Day, nobody ever knew for sure. But later there was a change in the way things were.
Look, it's no big deal, okay?
It's settled. Sometimes people make mistakes. It's a human thing. Curiosity, that's all.
An ambush? Ambush with the Greenies?
Yeah, well, no more.
Marianne.
Hey.
Top's a pretty color. Makes your eyes sparkle.
Thank you.
So come on now, Belle, tell me. What was it like out there?
What about Charlie? Did you see any VC? Come on, is it like what they say? Like walking into hell? Come on, Belle, you gotta tell us now.
It's nothing.
Marianne, we're all family here. Did you ambush along the river or up west in the mountains? Wild Bill said there's a VC village up there. Were you up there? What happened? And what's it feel like?
Eddie. Your food's getting cold. Come on, let the lady eat. She's got to be starving. Marianne, maybe you can make some of that Coon Trang stuff again.
Yeah.
That was a little lady.
Sleeping like a baby.
The untroubled sleep of the innocent. A simple child that lightly draws its breath. What does it know of death?
What's that supposed to mean?
A little Shakespeare. It's kind of like what Eddie's talking about all these times. If we had a woman for president, there wouldn't be any Vietnam, no more wars.
Maybe Eddie's got a point.
Pure garbage. Stick them in the zoo, they're just like us, no different.
They're not like us.
Why, because they're girls?
Yeah, because they're girls.
You got blinders on, man, when it comes to women, about how gentle and peaceful they are. You know, I've seen guys come out of the bush. Swear to God, they saw the Virgin Mary riding around on a goose or something. We buy it. We smile and ask how fast she was going or did she have spurs on. We just chalk it up as another guy who got caught up in the numb shit. You think just because they're girls, they got some special protection against it? Bullshit.
The fuck are you on about?
Nothing. I'm just saying that in the now, man, anything can happen.
You know,
if I were you, I'd just really take care of her, that's all.
Well, I'll tell you this much. There won't be any more late nights, no more ambushes.
You didn't lay down the law, did you?
I'll compromise. Put it to you this way. We're now officially engaged.
Congratulations, Fosse fucking A.
Thank you.
She's gonna make a beautiful bride, combat ready.
Congratulations, man.
Come on, pass your glasses.
All right.
Getting married.
Hey.
We're gonna have the best wedding Cleveland Heights has ever seen. We're gonna have a live band.
The Jesters.
That's right, the Jesters. A big sit-down dinner.
No rice and beans.
No rice and beans. Hell, we're having prime rib. Open bar, three kegs.
I'll drink to that.
Like a real Irish wedding.
No, better. A two-day party. I guarantee you no one will be standing at the end of it.
Fireworks.
Fireworks, yes. I forgot fireworks. Fireworks. I mean, you only get married once, right?
Eddie, maybe we can smuggle out some of them trip flares, really light up your soiree.
At least something good came out of this war, huh?
You guys gotta be there, okay? You gotta make it. I mean, we're counting on you. Every one of you. Right, honey?
Yeah. Seriously, I mean, you're our second family. It wouldn't be right without you.
And besides, you're all in the wedding party. Isn't that what we decided?
Mm-hmm. Out of blue tuxes for the ushers, and I'm gonna have the bridesmaids in pink.
I can dig it. We'll look just like the four tops.
To the happy couple. Congratulations.
Something to look forward to, eh?
Keeps hope alive.
Indefinitely.
talked to Wild Bill today. There's a C-130 from Chile at 0600 hours, straight to Saigon. You'd only have to wait a couple hours. Then I got you on a Brenna flight direct to LA from their home. It's time, you know that.
Okay. That's what you want?
It's not that I want you to go. I don't want you to go, you know that. I want to be with you every second. You're in my heart, you know that. It was fun, right? I mean, you have a couple unbelievable stories to tell your girlfriend, right?
Yeah.
I'll be home real soon. And we'll do the wedding and all that, you know, the rest of our lives. I mean, how we kid around this place is still ma'am.
You don't have to explain. I understand. I understand everything.
Where is she? Fuck! Fuck! Fuck!
In your hands, my son, the future and destiny of Shangri-La. Now you know why I can't leave.
I really don't know what to say. But you must be completely mad.
You think I'm mad?
Should have never fucking brought her over here.
Shoulda? A little late for that, isn't it?
But she was just an innocent kid out of high school.
Weren't we all?
Well, maybe you didn't have to give her that Amazon Woman Warrior shit, Eddie.
Shut your fucking mouth.
Don't know how to use the M16.
Don't put that shit on me.
No, you're the fucking lifer in here, ain't you?
Fuck you, bud.
Give it a fucking rest. Let's face it. We all liked having her here. This is not Yankee Stadium. You don't get to sit in the fucking bleachers and watch. This is a war. Nothing more to say. I feel terrible. I know. Okay, maybe I don't know. But you gotta stop this, man. All you need is some time. Some mental R&R. Come on, man. Talk to me.
Thank you.
They've been gone about 3 weeks. No, who the fuck knows what. Anyway, I was the first one to see her. So I had to tell Fossey. Franks and beans. Come on, man, you gotta eat.
She has to come out. Go bring her home.
Look, man, it's your call. But I would not go fucking around with those greenies.
I'd give up my life for her.
You do what you gotta do. But I'd be extra polite. Something.
Inside. Come on now.
You hear that, Eddie?
It's just somebody's radio. It's
all there is. You hear it's her.
Come on. Come on now, please.
It's Mary.
Please.
Just listen.
Please come.
Just
please.
Listen.
Please come up.
Before. Listen!
No sense talking. I know what you're thinking, but it's not. It's not bad.
Bad.
How I feel. When I'm out there at night, I can feel my blood moving. My skin. My fingernails. Everything. It's like I'm full of electricity and I'm glowing in the dark. I'm on fire. I'm burning into nothing. And it doesn't matter because I know who I am and you can't feel like that anywhere else. It's not your fault, Mark. You're just in a place where you don't belong.
Do something.
What do you want me to do?
I can't let it go.
Didn't you fucking hear her in there? She's gone. She's gone, man.
Come on.
What next?
Next?
Yeah, the girl. What happened to her?
I don't know. 3 days later, I got orders to report to Alpha Company. Hitched a ride with Wild Bill. Last time I ever saw the fucking place. Marianne, too.
You fucking with me, soldier?
Why, Lieutenant?
It's against the rules. Against human nature. This elaborate story. You can't just say, by the way, I don't know the fucking ending. You got certain obligations.
Okay. Look, everything I told you up till now is from personal experience, right? The exact truth. To hear a few things. Second hand, well, third hand, actually. So from here on in, it becomes, what do you call it?
Speculation.
Right. Speculation.
So?
I was over in Bangkok, ran into Eddie Diamond. I was on R&R, pure fluke thing. He told me a few things, but I can't vouch for them with my own eyes. In fact, Eddie didn't even see it. One of the greenies told him.
What do you see?
Nothing. You know, remember, this is just pure speculation.
Well, go on. Finish up.
He said she was starting to really like it. I mean, really, really like it. I heard her once say, Vietnam made her glow in the dark. Glow in the fucking dark. She took greedy pleasure in patrols. She was good. She had the moves. After a while, she went barefoot. There were times, apparently, when she took crazy death wish chances. Things even the greenies balked at. Morning, she walked off into the mountains, and she did not come back. I never found her body, no equipment, no clothing. They never found nothing. For all I know, she could still be alive.
Yeah, maybe up in one of those high mountain villas.
Hey.
Maybe with the Mutton Yard tribes.
Yeah. Yeah. Just speculation.
Well. Yeah.
There was an inquiry, of course, and a week-long air search. The compound was crawling with MPs and CID types. In the end, however, nothing came of it.
Look at me! You guys are running some Shangri La beer, imported poontang? What is the fucking deal, soldier? Your ass is mine! Look at me!
Fosse was busted to PFC and shipped back to a hospital in the States. A couple of months later, they gave him a medical discharge. We all did. It's just the way Marianne looked. She reminded us of all those girls back home, you know. So innocent and clean. They wouldn't understand any of this shit. You could try and tell them, they just stare up at you with them big candy eyes. It'd be like trying to tell someone what chocolate tastes like.
Shit.
There it is. You gotta taste it. She was here, man. With her fucking eyeballs in it. I guess that's why I loved her.
Come on!